What really branches you to be, I guess, the best of the best and a success story past skills? You know, what takes it in that little ball of skill set to really emphasize it?
Well, I think it's the lifestyle that you choose to live. It's the person that is not going to make an excuse. It's someone that's going to show up and put his whole heart effort into it. The successes of being able to show up and do their job and learn a craft and learn a skill. It's not necessarily being the best student grade-wise. It's about coming in and putting 110% effort all the time. Showing up, doing a good job, being able to be honest, be efficient, and be able to do what you say you're going to do.
Well, to do well in these classes, I highly recommend showing up on time, getting in as much practical practice as you can. You know, if you get the opportunity to work, work, because you're only going to hurt yourself if you don't put in the time. I would ask questions. I've had a lot of help from the other students in class, as well as people who've been through the program already.
One very, very big thing that Ryan and I expect is that you have to be an independent, a free thinker, and motivated, self-motivated. And if you're not, we can help you with that. And I think everybody has that. And it's essential that you have those skills beyond just the welding and the academics, but really, you gotta be self-motivated and be self-inspiring.
Well, you know, Jesse, that's what that most people call soft skills. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people think those are somebody that you either have or you don't have. Well, everybody has it. We just try to expose you on how you become better with those soft skills.
Communication is huge, especially when you're working with people. You not only have to deal with everybody, but you're going to deal with people that you don't like, but you got to still work with them to get the job done. So it's putting your differences aside to get the job done.
Meet a mentor. A mentor like Ryan Eubank, who was mine, Ryan really, really emphasized the work ethic, the skills. You're going to learn how to have a work ethic. You're going to learn that it is going to be dirty. It's going to be a little hard, but you know what? It's going to pay out extremely well for you in the next few years.
It gives you kind of a sense of purpose. You know what's expected of you. You come in and you do the work. I find a great level of pride and satisfaction in the work, and the friends that I've had through the program have had the same. They're happier. They're making the money that they want to make. They know what's expected of them, and they're doing what they enjoy doing.
Well, what we're looking for is those top 10 percenters, those individuals that want to come to school every day. They're eager to learn. They're eager to learn a skilled trade, getting into the skilled trade to be able to produce an income that can support their family for the rest of their lives. If they come in and they show up and they do a great job every day, they can become successful in this particular field.
Everything's on a personal level where if you want to get a job, get a better job, you have to develop yourself. You can't expect someone to push you into a better position.
All I had was my sense of pride and my work ethic that would keep me there. But if you go in and you work and you put your heart into it, then I mean, you're gonna go anywhere. You can do anything.
Well, the welding field is not going away. It's only getting stronger. The demand for the jobs and the skilled workers are better now than they ever been. AWS, American Welding Society, is projecting there's going to be over a shortage of 250,000 welding jobs available in North America alone. So if you're looking at getting into a career path, welding is it. It's not going away, it's only getting better, and it's needing you now.